So, welcome everyone. Just had a big fail. I said hello and everything and I failed to press the start button. So now again, welcome to the first stream of Sim Airport. It's an airport building game. And yeah, my idea was to just let you decide what I should build, which airline we should accept, how much we should charge them, and so on. So in this first episode I wanted to quickly give you an overview of the airport I have built so far, and then we will start a whole new game together. Yeah, that's my idea of this stream episode. So we have quite a big airport which I built like last week, and then I had this idea maybe I could stream this game and let my viewers decide on how much we should charge the airlines, like you can see here, or which airline to accept, like Lufthansa, some premium airlines, or more of the budget airlines, EasyJet and Ryanair. If we should make a minimalistic design and rip off the people in crowded cafes, or if we should do some more premium stuff. So that's all yours to decide now. I'm looking forward to some suggestions. I'm pretty experienced in how this game works, and yeah, I have about 300 hours of playing time. So let's go ahead and start a new game together. And we can do all this together. A new game. We will start a career mode and we will start from scratch. And we also don't want this because I like my way of building stuff, so we get a little bit more head start. And now the first decision would be which airline should we use. So at the moment I have 330 installed mods of airlines, so it would be great if you could give me a general idea of which airlines you would want to see in our airport we build together. It doesn't have to make sense like in the real world. We could have some Scoot from Asia, and then I don't know, EasyJet and some regional airlines from America, I don't mind. So just put in some input in the chat, that would be nice. I see Etihad Airways and Air Canada. Yes, we have that. We have Air Canada, Air Canada Express, Air Canada Rouge, Etihad Airways and Air Baltic. Oh, Air Baltic is nice because they have the A220, one of my favorite aircraft. So we have to decide a little bit if we want to have a budget airport or a mixed airport or some only premium airlines. Where's Air Baltic? Must be in the top here. Air Baltic. Then we have a lot of Polish airlines. I think we have that as well. But first, Etihad Airways. Etihad Airways. Lot Polish Airlines, yes. Lot here. Any more? We need some money making airlines, I guess, and some wide body jets, so we take Lufthansa from me. And maybe KLM. Anything more? I guess we need at least like 20 airlines or so. Air France and TAP, yes. TAP Portugal. Norwegian and Qatar, okay. Norwegian. There's Norwegian Airlines. Ryanair and Wizz Air all the way, yes. So let me get Qatar Airways first. Qatar Airways, EasyJet, sure, EasyJet. Here's Ryanair. We also have German Wings, Eurowings, and we have pretty much every airline that exists. So Ethiopian Airlines, yes. Wizz Air. Where's EasyJet first? EasyJet. Philippine Airlines. Here's Philippine Airlines. British Airways. Swiss. Swiss. Austrian. Finnair, okay, Finnair, Korean Air. Korean Air is nice, they also have the A220. Ethiopian. Ethiopian Airlines. Finnair. Finnair is here. And Korean Air. We also have Wizz Air was suggested. So right now it looks like a bit of a budget airline, airport. Qatar Airways is also included already. Sadly we don't have Air Cubana. That's sad. WestJet from Canada. Pier Pakistan. I've booked a flight on Pier Pakistan Airlines, but sadly the corona came in the way and also the connection I did book would have missed my flight, so I'm not so sad. Emirates, okay. With a whole lot of suggestions coming in, I might as well just select every airline. Virgin Atlantic. We have Virgin Atlantic here. El Al. Okay, I think we have enough now. Aer Lingus, sure. What about Azerbaijan Airlines? Pretty much like that airline. Where's Aer Lingus? I need a search bar for the airlines. So many. Aer Lingus. Sadly, I don't have a face cam at the moment, but maybe if we continue the series, we will get a face cam here. Yeah. Air Serbia. Asiana. I think I have Asiana. So we could think of a name of our airport, because now we have a whole lot of different airlines from different continents. So did I check Air France? I don't think so. Here, Air France. I missed Royal Jordanian and Air Serbia. Air Serbia, Royal Jordanian. Oh, there's Pier Pakistan. Royal Jordanian is gone, so somehow. WestJet, yes, I forgot WestJet. but it's not this one, it's this one. Cathay Pacific. Okay, we get two more and then we would start the game. Cathay Pacific. That's a difficult one because they only have big planes, I guess. Cathay Pacific here. Singapore Airlines. One way airline, so please wait, please vote. Singapore Airlines or Eurowings or Azul. Yeah, did I get Emirates? No, I didn't. Okay, we take every suggestion you put in. Eurowings, Singapore Airlines, and Azul, if I have it, I'm not sure. Azure Air, yeah, it's not the same. Okay, Singapore Airlines, you got it. Okay, now we start the game. 150 million, and that's it. I don't want to add too many airlines because then it's too easy. So welcome in the game. Right now we have to make a few decisions, how much we want to charge the airlines and how we want to design the whole area. We have a design tool here. My first start would be to do some runway planning. So mostly start with the small gates and I do two runways and I leave a little gap between them so we can have taxiways running all around them like this. And then leave a gap here so we can have some remote gates, and then we can start the terminal area over here with some small gates for the first flights. Smooth Flying is asking what's the difference between Airport CEO and this game. So basically, I don't know, Sim Airport was the first one to come out, I guess, and that's the one I played since day one. Airport CEO is a bit more in-depth, I guess, so yeah, I don't know, I find the difficulty level if you're starting this game much harder, so I prefer Sim Airport. But yeah, Airport CEO is a bit more realistic in that way. That's right. So here we have a gap of 20. That's nice. Yeah, so now we start with the first thing. We will build the runway. And the first taxiways. I always start like this because then I know I will have enough money to build the rest. Okay, right now we have two workers which will construct our airport. So let's get some more. Or you tell me. You have to decide how we run this airport. You want to have a lot of workers or just a few of them. It's all a question of money. So let's get some suggestions from you. Should we have a fast build or make it slow? A lot of workers, okay. Yeah, that's better, I guess. So let's start with 20, 30. Yes, my airport code is PSB, Plane Spotting Berlin. That would be nice. So, with this taxiway arrangement, we don't have so much space here for further growth. So let's put down our first gates. Let's start with one gate, the small gates. The runway length is okay for now. You only need 9 tiles in this game. I know it looks a bit small, but we don't have enough space to make it a lot bigger, so it will get bigger once we have some more aircraft coming here. And while I say that, we can start some research. We have a whole lot to research here, so we might as well get started with operations, so we get upgraded buses and stuff, so we can get more passengers, which we will need quickly. This game is not available on mobile games, mobile phones, no. And the moderators, so far I don't need one. Yeah, so now we have to start planning the terminal. So I will start quite small, if you don't mind. Let's let the chat decide how big our first terminal will be. There is a train line running here, so we will connect that later on, but we will have to research it first here. Light rail transit. But at the moment we don't need it anyways. A huge airport, okay. But you want me to start with some budget airlines or some high 5-star airlines? I don't know. The first airline should be Qatar Airways, yeah? That's a nice idea. We'll have to see about that. We can look at the contracts. We don't have any contracts of small airlines. Qatar Airways, let's have a look. The Budapest low-cost terminal, yes, that's my favorite. But now it's renewed, so I don't think so. Okay, we have some Qatar Airways flights here, but only in the evening, so we have to build some runway lights first. Yeah, we will do a mix because we have so many budget airlines in the game right now. Uppsala. So maybe let's get some runway lights here and then start with the terminal. So first I won't do it so big. Give me 20. Make it 20 by 10 first. Then the outside services. So yes, we can expand this airport in the future. We still have to research it first. So there's a point of land expansion, However, it's quite expensive, so we first have to get in some flights to get some cash rolling. So let's speed this up, get this built, and then if we have all the infrastructure we need, so we need some ticketing desks, we need some security, we need some shops, we need some gate areas, we need a whole lot of stuff before we can accept the first flight. And now you could decide how you want to handle this airport, so I can show you. In the operations tab we have a bag scanner, which is the normal one we have to use first. So this one uses some stuff. But then for the gate area we do have some quick boarding gates which do not need personnel. So that would be a nice idea to save some money at first. And we even have some ticketing desks where you don't need staff. We also have some smaller security checkpoints which don't need staff, so we have one with staff and one without. Yeah, we could build a little shopping mall here, like you pass the security check, like say security is here. On this side. And then we could do some coffee or shop here. A duty free shop, yeah. One terminal for low cost carriers, okay. Yeah, that's a nice idea. However, I would say that the first one will get mixed, and the second one, let's say we put a row of small gates here and make it mixed, and later on when we add some outside gates in this area we will just do like a side terminal here and then have buses drive from here to there, if that makes sense. Okay, first we need security zone. No, the train is actually in the game, passes here every hour. Like the bus is already running, even though we don't need it. One thing you could hear from here is airplanes, because I live near the airport in Berlin. So let's start with the gate area. You want to have the quick boarding gates, or you want to have the real gate agent desk, which requires staff, which costs money. Your choice. The quick boarding, yes. Save me some money, that would be nice. Let's put two of them, that's enough for an A320 or 737. That's the biggest aircraft we can handle with this small gate here. And then let's put some information screens there and maybe a garbage bin. So on this side I would like to have some how do we do this best so I would like to have a duty free shop. Let's make a store here, like 10 by 10, and then have a wall here No, we have enough space. We have enough space there, so we just let's make it a bit smaller. And then 10 like this. And we will do a cafe here. Get a lot of cash. 15 euros for can of Coke. Yeah, that's a good idea. We can try that. So we have some retail stuff here. We have a drink vending machine. Not sure if you can charge $15 or 15 euros. You also have a Coca-Cola machine. Let's place this one down. And also a food vending machine. Okay, let's start with the security zone. We need some metal detectors and back scanners. Let's start with 3. And we take the metal detectors without staff, so we can save some money on personnel here. I want to always make the most money of the little space we have here. So I usually try to put as many gates and as many flights as possible. Yeah, the Qatari, in Qatar the water is very expensive, I know that. I've been there 2 times, no, 4 times now. But luckily the last times I was there, I was able to get the access to the Priority Pass lounge, so I didn't have to pay extra for water. That's nice. So we need some ticketing kiosks. I guess we will take the automated ones. So now we have a connection here. How will the people get out? 1, 2. Let's make it like this. 2. Just to start, we will make a little wall here, and then we put the security exit there. And then we have a baggage claim without any belts. So they can collect their luggage here. Yes, half our money is gone. But that's not a problem. We have enough money now. I will now place down some ticketing desks where the people can check in. 1, 2. And I already have a space issue here, so I cancel this one. And we put down some ticketing machines. Actually, before I started the stream, I was thinking about adding a new airline. and maxing out like all the credits you can get. So the airlines have different expectations of your airport. So you have communication, passenger satisfaction, commercial fees, and trust. So if this is very low, like 3% here, they won't offer you any flights. And also you can change the contract bonus, like this one is 2,500 euros if I accept one flight of them. So we will get 2,500 euros. I thought about changing that, but I decided not to. And let's get some ILS systems for this runway here. So if the weather gets any better, any worse, we can still land airplanes. I think the crosswind limit is 20 knots now, so we should be fine. And it's 1 o'clock, so we missed the time to select new flights. Too bad. Let's make this some security zone here. We will also be able to change all the floors here once we have enough money. Just get some flooring here to make it look nicer, and we have to collect or connect these gates, so that requires a security area. Okay, we still need to place down the fence, put it here and all the way up here. So this is our airside area, this is our landside area. The first flight is coming next day. We still have to finish the airport build. So now we have all the zones we need. We need some ticketing, which we have here. We have the security zone. So we should be good now. We can start finance. And we should build some offices soon. So maybe I can just, I don't know, no, currently it is almost 5 p.m. for me. Usually I just put a shitbox here to put some tiny offices for our people here so we can start our research better. And now, as they finish the building here, we can look for the first flights we can accept. So let's have a look for Qatar Airways. We have one flight in the night, a Boeing 737 MAX 8. Should we take that? It's not going to be our first flight, but the first flight from Qatar Airways. I just take it. We have Lufthansa A321neo. So based off of my experience, we can push this all the way to 1 hour and 20 turnaround times with the small gates, so we can put in as many flights as possible. Or if you say no, we want to have like a night flying stop, let's say the last flight should leave at 10 p.m. and the first flight should arrive at, I don't know, 4 in the morning. We could also do that, but we will lose a lot of money. You want a Ryanair flight, okay? A Ryanair flight in the morning. 6 o'clock. Usually the turnaround time is 25 minutes, but we cannot do that. Okay, next airline. Philippine Airlines. I'm not sure if we have one. I think Philippine Airlines, we need a little bit more. We need some high paid people to get these flights. Lot Polish Airlines, let's see. Yes, we have some. Let's take the morning one. EasyJet Air Serbia. So look, EasyJet in the morning. Yep. So at first it will be a little bit of mix between airlines here. Air Serbia, Serbia, yes. And WestJet flight, okay. WestJet. Let's take the MAX 7, has a nice livery. And let's try to condense them together. Air Canada flight. Canada Express, Air Canada. Ooh, yes, CS300. So the A220. And we have Wizz Air. Yep. Let's take a morning flight of Wizz Air. And Emirates is not available on the small gate. Pia Pakistan. Oh, they have an A320. That's nice. And now, as you can see, all the airline contracts disappeared because we have to build an ATC tower first. But let's do that quickly so we can get more flights. KLM was suggested, okay. Ah, we have to wait until it's built. So let's have a look at the cafe. We also need a kitchen for that, so let's have a look if we can build some kitchen here. Like that.
Zeit ist auf.
Okay, now we can build a kitchen. We need a door for that so the staff can go in and out. And we also need some shelves to store all the food items. Fridge here. The first flights will come in at midnight, so very soon. Let me quickly set up this cafe so we can get some money once the people roll in here. So let's start with some payment areas, and also we need a lot of drink possibilities, as well as some food items here. And we also need some tables for the people to sit down. And of course it's raining now. You're right, we wanted to do it 15, but we only can do it 10. No free water, yeah. We don't have a toilet anyway, so... enjoy your ride to Hamburg, Felix. So let's speed up the time a bit, so we can get our first flight in. We need some security staff here. They missed also the kitchen is not complete. So we need a cooker, a pizza oven, and also a sink to clean everything, and we need a hot plate. Let's do like this. Some place to prepare the stuff. Before I forget, we can also fill up our schedule now because the tower has been built. So let's get in some more airlines. No, there's no costumes desk, sadly. But it makes it a bit easier for me. So we have LOT Polish Airlines in the afternoon we can take. We have a Canada Rouge in the afternoon we can take. And we have a Ryanair flight in the afternoon we can take. So let's do that. And we can also start expanding another gate if you like. Norwegian, 737 MAX 8. Very realistic. And some more easy jet flights, you say? Okay, in the afternoon, A319. One big gate, yeah, the big gates will come later because we have to make a longer runway for that. And I can show you that. If I build a runway starting here, you can see all the aircraft types that I can land here. And if we want to land like a 747, I think 747, where are you? See, this is not even long enough and we already crashed through the road and the ATC tower, so we will need to buy additional land over here. So later on. Let's get the security in. Let's hire some more. Let's get some janitors to clean our floors. Some retail workers to buy our food. And some chefs to prepare the meals in the kitchen. So let's connect the kitchen like this. And I also want to get some advertisement in here to generate a bit more money. This is usually a good spot in the middle here. And there are our first people. So we will get the first flight very soon. But we don't even have stock in our kitchen now. So nobody can purchase anything here. A terminal just for EasyJet. Sadly, that will not work, sadly, because we only can get a set amount of flights from every airline. We have one more gap to fill in the evening, I see. So the last one, maybe Eurowings. Lufthansa, what do you have to offer? Ooh, ambulance. Korean Air. Let's get Korean Air in. So the gate is fully occupied now. 10 minutes gaps in between the flights. That should be enough. And we should see our first arrival. There it is. It's Pier Pakistan. All the people get off. And here you see the luggage is already handled by this guy. So you'll just drop off the luggage here and the people can collect it there. And we have completed the boarding already. 50 of 50 passengers on board. What's going on here? Police? And he's off about 1 hour early. No, sadly we cannot make the boarding quicker. But usually the boarding is pretty quick. So the most time spent on getting the luggage to the gate. Bye bye. Thank you for the $400. But later on we can make some conveyor system so we can transfer the luggage to the apron area and then have some vehicles drive them around to the gates. Yeah. We have some drunk passengers from the Coke we sell here. I think you have to be very drunk to sell a Coke bottle for $10, right? The food is okay. And you can see here, most passengers will grab these drinks. I'm not sure how much they charge for it, but I know they are pretty popular, so. Also, our chef started to prepare the first meal, so let's get some more. Let's say 3. And the ticketing area is empty. So let's see if we can build another gate here. We have enough money right now. So we can get in more flights, more people. Before I forget, I wanted to make the offices. So we can do some more research. some office areas. Here's Wizz Air, second flight of the day. We could also think about maybe increasing our prices for the runway usage. What do you guys think? If we do it too much, the airlines won't offer any flights anymore. So we have to be a bit careful. But we also need to make some money to expand more. So what do you say? Increase the price or not? Currently the runway fee is $400 per landing and per takeoff again, so $800 and $10 per passenger. So this flight has 35 passengers, it's not a lot. Increase to $600, okay. And the terminal fees could be 15. Double the prices sounds good. So 20 and 800. Yeah, we do that. So now we cannot change it for the next 24 hours. And we could also think about getting something in the store here. So what do you guys want to sell in our store? We have a lot of different things. We have books, candy, clothes, jewelry, makeup, pharmacy. That's good for the Ryanair flights, I guess. Sunglasses and alcohol are not included, sadly. Coke is not included as well. Souvenirs. And that's it. You can have a look at what we have as well here. Car rental, slot machines, SIM card vending. Flowers, coffee, different arcade style stuff. You can also do some loose. ATM is always good, so people can spend more money. Let's put one here. And our second flight also left on time. We can do a little bit of a mixed store here. So at first we don't specialize too much. Just put in a little bit of everything. Some cashiers. Set some clothes. Yep. And some makeup maybe. And souvenirs is always nice. Shoes. And some candy. And because we still have money, let's get some expensive stuff. The profit of one sold item is $105. That should be good. And they all already missed the next departure. Or the next three departures, so quick. Okay, we can hire some admins to do some more research now. There's a lot Polish Airlines. I don't know why they need 6 flight crew for this flight. Not sure where they're going. 37 people. That's not a lot. Betsy Big Nose asks if I will be buying the Microsoft Flight Simulator. I already did. Maybe I can do a live stream of that, but I'm not a pro in flight sims, so you're not missing out on a lot. So we have the store set up here. Still need to wait until midnight until we get delivery. And I'm just seeing we are already missing out on transit capacity, so we need to increase the numbers of buses. Or at least upgrade the buses. Okay, let's get rid of this wall here. The rail connection is for later on. It's too expensive right now. Look, we have to research for 50,000, and then we have to buy the station for, how much is it, 200,000, so it's a bit expensive right now. Also, we don't need it yet, still have enough bus capacity. Let's get in some doors here. I'm thinking this was maybe not the best idea to set up, because expanding this will be a bit tricky, but we will see. A lot of people use the ATM here. Maybe you can increase the price. And put some adverts right into the people here, so we get a lot of revenue from that. This is the next flight from Air Canada Rouge. Hopefully they have some more passengers for us. 45, wow. So we can already accept the next flights. What do you want to have for the next? Any wishes for the next flights? LL was suggested. Let's take one of TAP Portugal. Lufthansa, yes. We also have another Pier Pakistan flight. And some more LOT Polish Airlines. Ethiopian Airlines, we have an afternoon flight. Kenya Airways is not in our safe game right now, sadly. We have too many budget airlines for the small ones here. So let's take this Eurowings flight in the morning. Yeah, sure. We already have some flights coming in here. 21 passengers only. Qatar Airways is not offering any small flights at the moment. We only have the large ones. Swiss CS300, CS100. Let's also take this Ethiopian Airlines Dash 8. The second Air Serbia one. And maybe one more Norwegian flight. You already have two Pierre Pakistan flights here. And in the morning, some WestJet. Ah, damn. One too many now. Gulfair is also not in our save game. We could have selected that, but when we started the game, we decided on 30 different ones. Air Canada again. Not sure, can we fit 3? Yeah. A320. And for the afternoon one, let's get some Ryanair. And we have one more gate slot open. Air New Zealand is also not in our safe game. Let's get some Wizz Air for the evening one. And we have the Air Canada A220 here. Very nice looking. Air China is also not in our safe game. Korean Air is in our schedule already. So in the late evening we will get the first flight. Now we should have upgraded buses in 12 hours. That's good. So let's think about operations too. So we can decide on how often they restock our kitchen and drink vending machines here. You can see it's already empty. No Coca-Cola left, so you have to buy this expensive shit here. Yep. Let's follow this EasyJet. He departed about 45 minutes early. That's good. Bye bye. And soon we should have the first Korean flight land yet. Any moment now? Whoa, that was a bit fast. So we can highlight our passengers to see where they are. So we can see if they are still stuck in security or stuff. But it seems like they are all sitting in the cafe or chilling by the gate. It's good. Welcome, welcome. Oh, we still need some more staff. So you can see here we have a little bit of problem in our cafe. We could make a lot of more money here. Korean Air at the gate right now. 61 passengers. It's also not even a half full flight. 1/3. The new gate is already open, but the first flight will come tomorrow. So in about 1.5 hours. And he left on time as well. Qatar Airways already landed at 6 p.m. So now we will get 2 flights per day at the same time. So here's Pure Pakistan Airlines and second one. LL. So as you can see, it's getting a little bit more crowded now. And we are making a profit as far as I can tell. Now we have to think about security, how we can make it bigger in the end. And for now we could also start putting in some more floors to make it a little bit nicer for the passengers. How many terminals? You can decide that on your own. The wide body jets will come a little bit later because we have only the small runways right now. And I first need to unlock the land expansion, and that's very expensive, so we cannot do the large planes right now. So let's get this floor built quickly. Yeah, we could build a walkway, but it's also very expensive, and I mean, the terminal will expand in this direction anyways, because we need to add some more ticketing counters and stuff. You can see the time in-game up here. Yes, now we have 2 planes at once. And look at how crowded our cafe is. That's nice money for us, I guess. And I would say, as we still have some money left, let's go for the next gate. And push some more people in. We need to expand quickly. Look at this WestJet 737 Max. Very much like the new painting. Qatar Airways is coming once a day at 6 p.m. So it's a little bit time left. Here we have the first Ryanair flight. Yeah, we could offer some chairs. Which one do you like? The cheap ones or the nicer ones? We have a bench like this, or like this. The cheap ones, yeah. We have the small budget airline terminal. It's not the budget airline terminal right now, but we have more budget airlines than nice airlines, I guess. Yes, we could improve our satisfaction. The environment is a little bit of a problem right now. We can have a look at this. We don't have any plants or so in our terminal. I could change that as well. No flight get cancelled. Can look yesterday, all the flights were on time, and we also get a bonus for that. So on day 3 we had 16 flights all on time, and we get a bonus. So let's do some benches. Maybe this way, with only 3 seats. And we have our first turboprop landing, Ethiopian Air. Let's see how many passengers they bring us. 10 people, wow. 5 pilots and cabin crew and 10 passengers, wow. It's not a lot. What happens if we don't have enough gates? We just build some more gates, I guess. That's the game, that's what the game all about. I can try to put as many gates as possible, if you want that. That's the whole idea of this series, you can decide what I want, or what I have to build. So let's get rid of this wall here, and open up the next gate area. Yes, we will make a huge airport, but it will take some time. So now we can look. Upgraded buses is almost ready. So the buses will be double the capacity. And after that we have operations too. So we can decide how often the bus will come. The security is a little bit crowded right now, so we can maybe add another one. Like this. ...75 minutes in a live game. Not quite. Yeah, sadly you cannot see if anyone brought something dangerous. Could also make some more ATMs, because they are still not enough. And also the food is very attractive here. So let's get in some decor maybe. Put in a nice fountain here. Maybe a tree on this end. More seating. Yes, I mean we could do that. In between here we can also add some more. Maybe we can do some arcade, where we can have some slot games, vending machines, retro games. Make the airport spacious, yeah. The problem right now is we don't have enough money for that, so we have to earn as much money as possible right now. We will make a quiet and peaceful area if we add the Singapore Airlines and Qatar Airways in the new terminal, maybe. So let's see if we can get any more flights for this third gate. We can also rename the gates to make A1, A2, A3. And let's get some more flights. We already have the WestJet one. Still, we can only choose from the small gates. Why is the security so simple? You have a bag scanner, a metal detector, and even an ID check, so that's like in real life, huh? Let's get some flights in. No, at the moment I think we are good with the security checks. Let's get a LOT Embraer. No, CRJ 900. More chairs, yeah, I don't want to spam too many chairs. We don't have so much space. I'd rather put in some stuff we can earn money with. Let's take the Ethiopian 737. And we don't have another flight of Qatar. So let's take EasyJet. I would love to add more Qatar flights, but we don't have one on offer right now, so it's not possible. Yep, the views went down, that's right. Let's get some more lot Polish Airlines. EasyJet. Like I said before, Qatar Airways only offers the big planes right now, so we need a longer runway and also larger gates. One more for the afternoon, so Ryanair it is. And we could also have a look at all the other airlines we cannot offer yet. A finance officer we can hire it as well. So we can see our stats on how much revenue we make. So now we should have some more airlines here. And there's Norwegian Airlines. So now we should have Air Baltic. Any evening flights? Swiss in the evening? No, we don't have any evening flights offered. And Eurowings we have... Yes, we have one. A220? A320. The problem with the Asian airlines now is that we already started the game and I cannot add any more airlines now. So maybe when I do another series we can do an all Asia airport or so, but now we will stick with mostly European airlines. Just give me one more. Pakistan Airlines. So now we have a total. Every gate slot is occupied. we still could earn more money if we put in more cashiers. That's good. That's very good. Okay, let's see how our airports cannot talk anymore. Let's see how our airport handles the next set of gate when more passengers will arrive. I think we can already start expanding this little area for our security checks. And we also need to add some more ticketing sooner or later. So let's expand this way. So we can add some more ATM machines to give us quite a lot of money and some food and drink. Let's put down some more benches here. Nope. There's so much we can still add. We can add more stores, we can add some bathrooms, we can add some arcade zones, all kind of different first class lounges, flight crew lounges. We can also make some offices for the airlines so we can negotiate some deals to get more money from them. There's so much we still have to do. Let's get in some maintenance. Okay, then let's see how this last gate addition will benefit us. And then I would say we end the stream for today. I think we have played for, yeah, more than 1 hour. So if you like this video, if you like the idea of this live stream, leave me a comment below. And yeah, if you want to see more, feel free to let me know, and I will try to come back maybe tomorrow. That's good you like it. Yes, we could separate the arrivals and departures. However, it takes quite a lot of space that we don't have at the moment. So we can do that if we maybe sell this airport at one point and then start a new one. So we will start off with the money we had. And then we can plan it a little bit bigger from the start. And it's almost time for the next flight on the first, on the third gate. And I see ticketing is getting a bit out of hand right now. So we should get some more ticketing in place. And maybe one more security checkpoint. And here should come our three. Now we get three aircraft at the same time. Oh, you see that? LOT Polish Airlines with the Nordica livery. ninety-two passengers, it's getting better. And 40 here. And the security is getting packed here. But we should be fine. Should start to make some money now. Not a lot. That's a bit stupid. I mean, the A320 and the 737 should be about the same size, and because there are different mods on out there, it looks a little bit strange sometimes. You could have two different 737s next to each other and they would have a different size. Yeah. I think we need to increase our price a little bit. Ooh. And we desperately need the operations too to get more buses in. So we can decide not one bus every 30 minutes, but maybe one bus every 15 minutes to get our numbers back up. You can see the green line here is our capacity. This is how many people can come via bus. And the red line is actually the demand for arrivals and the demand for departures. And here's the some peaks where if the aircraft is full, it might get up to this point. Fifty minutes, and then we can decide more buses. 15 minutes. Okay, now you can see we are well in the green. So far every flight has been on time and every passenger made it to the boarding gate, which is good. But also you can see from these numbers here, some planes, maybe this A320 only has 27 passengers or even 13. So if you see that an A220-300 could carry maybe 140 passengers and only 19 are on board, that's pretty sad. But this also has to do with the satisfaction, and we can work on this by hiring or selecting some reps so they will talk to the airline and try to get a good deal for us, so they can pay more money to us. But that's something we can only start, I think, at day 12. So yeah, I think we could stop the stream right now, unless you have some other ideas what I should add now. Then please leave a comment in the live chat. Yeah, we could add a lounge, sure. But maybe we'll save that for next time, because right now we only have a big percentage of low-cost carriers. Some bigger gates is a good idea, yeah? However, they have a different requirement, so the large gate requires a door on the second floor. In this game you can also skip to the underground, two layers, and to the top floors, layer 2 and 3. So we will have multiple floors later on, that's for sure. But usually I plan my gates, I can show you. Let's say we put some more gates here, and then on the other side we will add bigger gates which have access on the second floor. So we basically can use the space again. That's how I like to do it. It's maximizing the space we can use. But like I said, that's something for next time. We will save this game as Planespotting Berlin Airport. Okay. I hope you enjoyed this video, and for now I say goodbye. See you next time, maybe tomorrow if I have some time and you want to see more. Have a nice evening and see you tomorrow.